Hello!
And welcome.
It's Bravandrum.
How are we doing?
Now, we've got Murphy's and Caffrey's. We're going to do pork in...
We're going to season it and coat it in flour.
Yeah.
So we can fry it off. So ready to cook in the oven.
And then we're going to put half a tin of each into... So first,
right.
Pork.
Right, we're gonna
what we'll do is salt it up with salt. And
season it all.
Yes, season, that's the word. And it just basically sprinkles the salt over it, and then just over the steaks.
And
then use pepper. Sparingly across the steaks. I don't know if you can see it. There you go.
And then what I'll do is I'll just dab it in flour. Like that, so it's nice and coated. Put it to one side.
And then continue on. So, why do you season it and then cover it in flour?
Well, the idea is to keep it nice and, tasty, when you're cooking it. So, like, say for instance, if you do just fry it off, it'll just, like, stick to the pan and
It gives it a little chance in the pan.
Yeah.
Without it sticking to the pan.
It'll just stick to the pan and...
Does it add a little extra flavour doing this?
Well, yeah, it's like, when you... When you finish it off eating it, while you're eating it, that is, it sort of gives it that nice, keeps the whole texture of it.
Oh, that's cool. So it gives it it gives it a little extra texture.
Yeah. So keeps its size. You know what I mean.
So when we go to fry it off, we've got some basil, some garlic.
Well, the basil will add near to the end, you know what I mean?
Onions.
I'm just cutting it in.
And are we adding mushrooms?
Yeah, that one there to end as well, because mushrooms can go really quickly, cook really quickly. So, what we'll do is, after we've fried the pork, it'll leave a flavour in the pan.
Right, okay.
So the idea is the onions will bring the flavour out of the pan, and then we'll just add a bit of maybe garlic, basil, and just add some sauce, a bit of water, juice, just to lift it up, so you keep
right.
That flavour. The idea is to keep the flavour.
You can see.
And then we'll try and get a sauce out of it, and then...
So
just pour it over and then cook it in the oven.
Right, cool. So I'll see you in a bit. So we're back. The pork,
right.
As you can see, the pork's ready. The pan's hot. What have you put in the pan?
We put a bit of olive oil. I think Mum used Bertolli's. What we're going to do now is just whip, check if the pan's hot.
How do you know it's hot?
You'll feel it really hot.
How do you know if it's cold? Right, okay. But remember, keep your hand above the pan, don't actually touch the pan.
See, there it's starting to smoke a bit now, so
yeah.
What are they up at? It seasoned away.
You sort of pull it away when you put it
in.
Yeah,
so if you go towards yourself, you're just going to end up with it.
And don't drop it in.
No. Don't throw it in either.
So it's basically going to cook these off. How many each side?
A couple of seconds, because see there, it's coming straight off there now.
You smell the...
All I do is just getting that coating. See there, lovely coating there.
Like a whitey yellow sort of coating.
Sort of, feel it now, it's nice crusty coating there. Just have a feel there. Nice crusty coating. So, usually people say brown it off, you know what I mean?
Yeah. And that's what the term browning is just
yeah.
Like
make it from go from red to brown.
Yeah.
And then basically you're going to continue on with this.
What I'm going to do is do the same for each one. And then I'm going to, that needs a bit more, but see there, just put that in there and...
And then carry on.
Carry on.
Yeah. Okay, it's fried them off.
Right. What we're going to do now is throw a bit of onions in there. Just try and collect some flavours up, which the pork has left.
Have you used any oil for the onions, or are you using natural greases and whatever left out in the pan?
Well, they'll create flavour there, and maybe like put more onions in, oil in. Just let them cook a bit, let them sweat them out.
And I see you're breaking the onion up even more than it was before.
Yeah, just so it helps it to dissolve, you know what I mean?
I think a lot of burger stands do that as well, don't they?
There you go, just sort of give it a coating now, nice and coating.
It's got a colour to it now as well.
Now I'll throw a bit of garlic in there. Throw some mushrooms in there.
Yeah, they're big mushrooms. How you cut them up?
A lot of flavor. What is the mix? It makes it chunky. I mean, do you smell that garlic now?
Yeah, I smell it when I'm feeling it. It's on my finger. So you've added the onions, you've added a bit of garlic. Crushed garlic, it was old garlic, Stuart, and then crushed it.
Stuart crushed it himself, yeah. You know what I mean?
With,
so,
with these horn hands that my parents give me when I was a little child.
First time he's ever done that in his life.
And probably last time, if we all die of food poisoning.
Now I'm going to just add some of this white sauce.
What kind of white sauce is it?
Oh,
wow, it's a lot of white sauce.
I sort of went for the Dormio because it was all it needed was just a bit of white sauce.
The pasta bake sauce for carbonara.
All I wanted was just a bit of white sauce, just to give it a thick texture, nice little thick texture. Let that cook off a bit.
You add any of this, or do you add it late?
Let that cook off for a little bit.
You let it reduce, as in let it, when you say cook off, it actually gets a smaller amount, doesn't it?
Just give it a couple of minutes. Let the sauce warm up a bit. Add the basil, and then just pour it over.
You put it in trays, you can see.
One side we're going to...
Caffrey's.
And one side Murphy's.
Well, yeah. Alright, see you in a bit. Okay, I'm getting out. Okay.
Right, I'm going to throw some basil in there just to give it an extra little bit of flavour. Just put that in there. Smells lovely, that basil. Looking good there. Now what I'm going to do now is just sort of pour it over the pork.
So you spoon it over the pork?
Yeah. It's easy enough, you know what I mean? So try and get the mushrooms in there.
And you make sure it covers the entire part of the pork?
Yeah, because otherwise it'll just... won't get cooked. Then... what we're going to do is add the beer to it. Now, I'll just put that to one side.
So, don't hit me in the face with it. So,
might actually need the spoon. So, I'll just do So, what
are
we going to do?
One Caffrey's and one Murphy's.
Alright, here we go.
Smoke off that.
Woo! So, I'll just pour. So, that's about half.
A bit more, because you can see it.
A bit more. Is that about right?
Yeah, it's about right.
And then half a Caffrey's.
You should put it in glass, really, and then just pour it through glass.
Yeah.
We'll get a glass.
So get a glass.
Just be safe.
Alright. Just about half it.
Yeah.
I'll pour that one. And there.
Yeah, it's about even, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, just give it a little stir around. And just cover that in foil. And straight in the oven.
So we'll see you when the finished is finished. Okay, right, Andrew's...
We've got the, I'm going to dig out the Murphy's one first. It's a nice thick texture there. We've got the fork in the middle. Smells nice.
How much longer would you reckon?
I'd say that's just about ready, but we can let it keep warm in there. As for the Caffrey's, it's lovely. Nice.
Ooh, you can smell that. That smells nice.
You smell the Caffrey's.
Ooh.
Nice and creamy there. I think it sort of it looked smelled better with the Caffrey. I think, I'm not sure, but we'll find out later.
Yeah. Okay, we've got the pork now. Show it.
If you notice the difference, this one is the Murphy's. It's a darker, richer colour. And the Caffrey's, sort of a light, creamy colour.
Yeah. So we're going to try the Murphy's first.
Alright.
So bring the plate over.
There we go.
I'll just have a taste of the...
You've got another fork there.
Yeah. Oh, that's a spoon. Fork and spoon. Right.
No, this one's the Murphy's. Super.
Slightly creamy.
Mm.
Pops really nice and succulent.
Mm.
Yeah, I don't think that it's got this slight edge to it. Well,
but it's very creamy. Right, I'm gonna. Right, just put this on the side here.
But it's nice. It gives a nice change to having a normal just steak by itself, isn't it?
Yeah. I think I'm missing is the lemon. Needs a bit of lemon in it.
What to both are?
Yeah.
For me, I think the Murphy's is a little bit better. The Caffrey's is a bit little weak. It's not as succulent as well.
Yeah, I think the
it's a little dry.
Missing a bit of a zing.
It's a little bit more drier than the Caffrey's.
Yeah.
But, yeah. Well, it's nice to try some of.
Well, worth a try.
Yeah. We used oil that we saw today.
But the Murphys came out better. I mean, if we try some of the mushrooms.
Mmm. The mushrooms is really nice in there.
Try some of the sauce. Yeah, you can definitely get that Murphy's there.
It tastes the Murphy's in the sauce. So you probably make a nice sauce.
You definitely get the Caffrey's in it.
Ooh, the Caffrey's is a really nice sauce. So if you were to do something with it, I'd do it with as a sauce rather than a braise.
Yeah, I mean, for braising wise, nah, I don't think it worked.
No.
But separate, it worked.
Yeah, if you just do the steak and then just do the sauce separately. But you can't win well, but both really nice.
Very nice.
You take care.
Bye.
Bye.